Helen Yee here with Eyes on the Game, being joined by number two bantamweight contender in the world, new Las Vegas homeowner, and a happy belated birthday to you, Aljamain Sterling.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm 31 on the 31st, and it's crazy to see that I'm 31 years old now. It's crazy. It goes by so fast.
Coming off that huge win, very impressive win over Corey Sandhagen, but I do have to ask, how's your top golf skills?
Terrible. You know what it is? My wrist from the surgery, I can't bend my wrist. So when I pull back on my backswing, I can't follow through. So every time I do it, I hook. So the ball goes, but then it hooks every single time. So I can't really make it travel straight. So I actually been hitting lefty, and I crushed it twice. Well, twice when I played top golf yesterday. But when I was home, I was playing lefty too, and then I hit better on that side because my left wrist can actually bend, and I could keep the follow through consistent all the way through. And I can't do that with the right wrist, but this is my, I don't know. I do everything lefty and righty. I brush my teeth lefty and righty. Oh, I open bottles lefty and righty. It's weird.
You're one of those who can also write with both hands.
I wish I had that talent, but I can hold the pen with my left hand, but yeah. The handwriting ain't so clean.
But your golf skills are better than the schmoes. You don't want to see his.
Maybe we have to go play a game. And even I'm a switch hitter in baseball, too. It's a very fascinating thing. And it's not intentional. It's just It's how my body works.
Well, like I mentioned, very talented, coming off impressive UFC 250. But you're back in town. You were just in town cornering your friend, your teammate, Chris Weidman, get that victory. And then this weekend with Marab.
Yeah, big win for Chris, the Chris. He's back in the win column, and in a big way, in my opinion. It might not have been his prettiest performance, but in terms of all the other past performances and the anxiety of all the buildup and the critics with the fans, the critiquing, all that stuff. So for him to get that monkey off of his back over the 11th ranked guy who hasn't lost a fight in six fights, in Omari Akhmedov, that's a tough dude. Had a lot of success, beat some good guys. Ian Heinisch, who beat Shoeface on his UFC debut, I think that was. For him to come in and then beat Heinz like that. So I think the performance wasn't the greatest, as we all know, but he got it done. He showed his levels of his grappling. And honestly, at this stage of the game, it's like, why even get hit anymore? Go out there, do what you got to do, get the fight to the ground, Khabib everybody, or this new guy, Kazmat. Shamayev, I don't know, whatever. You guys know who I'm talking about. But that guy, it's like we all have this great wrestling ability, so why not mix that in with our Sarah BJJ black belt?
Yes, absolutely. Well, speaking of this weekend, the main and co-main event, I was watching your Weekly Scraps podcast. Great podcast, by the way. You guys should check it out. But I noticed for the main event and the co-main, you did not make a prediction.
It's so tough to do that. Stipe is such a great dude. DC is such a great dude. Both guys, family men, and I've hung out with both. Stipe's come out to Long Island to hang out with us, train with Volante, Chris Weidman. And DC, I've hung out with him on multiple occasions. I talk to him all the time. He's a great ball buster. They're both really super fun guys to be around. So with that being said, they're both talented. I would hate to see either man lose. It's not like Stipe's the youngest guy. DC's definitely not the youngest guy. It's hard to say who you want to win that fight. I don't want either guy to lose, but the best man has to win, you know? So I think both guys have keys to victory to make that fight easier or more difficult, depending on their approach to the game. So I think this weekend is going to be a very fun fight. And with Sean O'Malley and Chito Vera, that's a tough one because I think with Chito's last fight with Yadong, he didn't really trust his boxing that he let go of in that fight with Andre Ewell. He went out there and tattooed him against a guy who's known to be a phenomenal striker, long rangey. He's 35er with a 75-inch reach or something like that, which is insane. I'm 71, and that's pretty long. So 75, that's a significant reach advantage, and Chito went out there and pieced him up pretty good. But the fight with Song Yadong, he looked a little more gun-shy. If he gets the fight to the ground one time, that fight's over, in my opinion. I think the fight's over.
Yeah. But with you saying him, you know, being gun-shy, and I noticed you use the word hesitant in your podcast, I wanted to kind of ask you a bit more about that. Like, what do you think caused him to kind of be more, you know, gun-shy in that fight against Song Yadong?
I think the knockout power. That's a scary thing. When you see someone knock some other guys out and you're like, oh, because then you start watching their highlights and you start thinking that could potentially be you, which is true. But then you could kind of get in your own head, get in your own way. And I don't think he fought the fight that he should have. He didn't really throw a lot with the hands. And he got away from his kicking. I think he uses his kicking, especially against O'Malley, who moves a lot with footwork. Chop down the calf early. Get O'Malley to overcommit. Don't bite on too many of his fakes, because he does a great job faking. You saw what he did to Eddie Wineland. And he's got great accuracy. So I think he just has to believe in his abilities, and that's it. I don't think this is a gimme fight for Sean O'Malley. I think Sean O'Malley is going to actually be tested for once. And a lot of people are saying Sean is going to knock him out based on what? Him knocking out Wineland? I don't know. Wineland's kind of at the end of his career, and he's been in a lot of wars. So it's kind of unfair to say that. And I think a younger Wineland, just like a younger Faber, can take those shots that they took from Petey Yan and from Sean O'Malley, respectively.
But looking at the mental side of the fight game, for example, DC is going into this fight knowing that it's going to be his last. So do you think that affects him at all, like mentally?
A little bit, but I think it should affect him in a great way, knowing that it's your last fight. You got to just go out there and let it all hang out. Don't save it. Don't try to play it safe. Take the guy down. Do what you got to do. Play to your strengths. He did an interview with Ben Askren, and Ben Askren told him, like, just to let you know, if you want to take him down anytime, you can. It's just whether or not he could do that for 25 minutes and enduring the body work of Stipe, who has really good boxing, really good hands.
You did mention Khabib earlier. He has a big fight coming up against Justin Gaethje. Just curious to hear your thoughts on that matchup.
It's tough to say. We haven't seen Justin on his back. We know he can stand up, but we haven't seen him in any positions where he gets tied up by a good jiu-jitsu player and can see if he can escape. So we don't know what his jiu-jitsu game actually looks like. It's one thing to say, yeah, I'm a great wrestler and I can stop the takedowns, but if you get taken down, then what? Cage wrestling is not the same as wrestling in the open mat. You're bent down in a stance. It's different. So with that being said, Gaethje can knock him the fuck out, definitely. But can he actually connect like Conor did, you know? Conor couldn't really make that clean connection, and it ended up being the roles reversed. Khabib actually dropping Conor. So it's hard to bet against Khabib, and Gaethje's been a man on fire, but he tends to get dropped every fight. And just about every fight, not with the James Vick and Edson Barbosa, but those, he just kind of steamrolled those guys, and Cowboy Cerrone. So he's been looking great as of late, but I don't know. I can't really call it. I really can't call it, but it's hard for me to pick against Khabib. If I'm betting on this fight, I'm going to bet with smart money, and kind of like the Mayweather of the game, I'm going to bet Khabib.
And with Cody Garbrandt about to fight for the flyweight title and having to drop down to 125 against Deiveson Figueiredo, how do you think he'll do?
I think Cody can say it's wrong or whatever, I'm talking shit, but I think he kind of ran from the fight with Marlon. That's the fight that they wanted to make. And maybe it wasn't his call. Maybe he did want to fight, and maybe Ali advised him to go down instead so that his guys don't have to fight. Ali's very good at that, not making his guys fight unless it's for a title shot. And smart on him. You know, he doesn't – no one takes a loss. They stay in title contention, and he can always bounce up back and forth. But that was a fight I was really interested in seeing, how good Cody really is if he take on a test like Marlon Moraes. And unfortunately, we won't get to see that. We'll see him at 25. He was knocked out 3 times in a row, had some knockouts before, once in the amateur circuit. I would imagine probably in the gym as well. It's happened to me, so I'm pretty sure it probably happened to him before. And especially having a training partner like TJ Dillashaw, who's so competitive, I would imagine that him going down to 25 is going to be very reminiscent of TJ going down to 25, and he won't be as durable taking those shots. So, yeah, he may be the bigger guy, but that doesn't always win when you're cutting down. I think you start to deplete yourself a little bit, and to want to have your brain fluids a lot lighter to make that weight class, I don't think it's the smartest thing. It's a good payday, but I can't foresee that going well unless he can connect first. So I think Figueiredo is durable right now. He's young, he can take the shots, and he can dish it. That guy puts his hands down, he just walks forward like the Terminator, and he's just swinging those things.
Well, what would you like to tell all your fans who are anticipating not only your return to the octagon, but to fight for the gold?
I just want to say thank you guys for always supporting me and tuning in. Whether you're a hater or a supporter, I still love you either way. You guys are who I do it for. And it's been a long road to get back to this position. I'm trying to realize a dream. And